Happy Thanksgiving, everybody!
Happy Turkey Day!
I've always wanted a good turkey gravy, and you gave that to me, so thank you.
Happy Thanksgiving, cutie!
Good morning, friends. Well, today is the day before Thanksgiving, and it's a busy one. As you know, the day before Thanksgiving is busy for everybody. So today, I'm starting off my day with homeschool, so I'm gonna jump on that right now. And then I am cooking up a storm and baking up a storm, so come along with me today. The boys are out doing their chores, working on the retainer wall, poopa scooping, mowing the lawn, and they're gonna clean out the garage. It is now 1:54. I just got done with school with Shaylee. She's working on an essay right now about the Mayflower. I am in my deep freezer, and I'm going in for all these pies to thaw them out, except for the blueberry. Okay, so I grabbed the rolls out of the freezer. These are the Costco rolls, so those will thaw. All right, here's the blueberry pie, which I'm going to bake right now, frozen. We do not thaw it. And this is a pumpkin pie, and this is a pumpkin pie. Oh, I'm missing another one. I gotta go grab another one. This is gonna be grandma's pumpkin pie that we're gonna bring to her, and then we have two for us. I mean, like I said, my boys can eat a whole pie. All right, I wanna show you guys what I did last night. I was prepping for today. So this is tonight's dinner. Kelly and Felix are probably gonna get in late, so we're still gonna make the ham dinner and everything, and that'll be there for them when they get here. So for today, this is what I'm doing today, Wednesday. So I'll be making a green bean casserole, a strawberry pretzel salad, the red cabbage, the cranberry sauce, and apple pie. I'm going to attempt a banana cream pie. We're gonna bake that blueberry pie, make shrimp dip, mincemeat pie for grandma. I already took the rolls out of the freezer, and cranberry salsa. That is all happening from now, 2 o'clock, until it's done tonight. And then tomorrow, I just need to make the gravy, the sweet potatoes, reheat the green bean casserole, take out the lemon pie, and make the deviled eggs. So tonight I'm gonna make a ham, new baked potatoes with garlic, asparagus, salad, rolls, and one of the pumpkin pies, and the chocolate cream pie. I really wanted to start this earlier, but I was working with Shaylee with school and doing some reviews, so now I know where we need to move forward with her for the next little bit, and that is more important than the food, but it's fine. I'm gonna put on my holiday music, put on a Christmas show, and get going. So, all right, the first thing I'm gonna do is get my blueberry pie in the oven. I'm gonna get it preheated right now. I just need to find the temperature. Also, I'm going to start on the Bestest red cabbage, because that takes a while to cook and work its magic and stuff. So that is going, that's the first thing I'm going to start cooking and preparing. I'm going to preheat my oven to 450. I'm going to make sure I put a tray underneath this pie because it will spill. All right, it is ready to go in. Oh, wait. I don't want to do what I did last year. I want to put an egg wash on this bad boy. I'll have the recipe down below. But remember, cook it frozen when you freeze it, okay? All right, here it goes. You're gonna need a red cabbage to make this yummy red cabbage recipe. Up to 3 pounds of finely shredded cabbage. I just decided I'm just gonna grab one because it's not something that everyone just digs in. It's acquired taste, and all the kids taste it, but I love it. Derek and I like it. So it's tradition. So I'm just gonna start finely shredding this guy here. This is 2 pounds, 3.3 ounces. I was just curious. I don't know if this is gonna work, but I covered it with aluminum foil because during the move, I must have got rid of the lid that goes with this because I can't find it and it doesn't fit right. So I have all my cabbage in there with a cup of water and 2 cups of vinegar. It's probably going to use a third, but I always start with 2. So that is going to cook on low for a couple of hours, and then I will look at it and work with it. I'll be adding like butter and sugar and probably more vinegar. So I'm gonna let it do its thing. Here is the ham that we are having, the brown sugar double glazed ham from Walmart. It is so good, hickory smoked, yum yum, spiral count. I am gonna cook it in my slow cooker. I do have a full video on how you could do this. I'm gonna put some brown sugar at the bottom. We're gonna use some canned pineapple. It's gonna be delicious. It's 2:30 right now, but we're not eating till later, so we're gonna be fine. So this will be in there. I'll start it on high for a little bit and then move it to low. Oh, this ham is so good. What I did was I put some brown sugar at the bottom, and then I trimmed the top to fit in the slow cooker. Sometimes I can't do this. Sometimes the bone is so tall and thick that I have to wrap my slow cooker in aluminum foil, but I never leave the house when I do that. If you end up needing to do that, do not leave your home. That to me is just probably the biggest fire danger. But I was able to slice off the top, and I'm gonna bag this up so when I make my split pea soup and other things that we need the ham for, we've got this yummy ham ready to go. So what I'm gonna do is sprinkle the top with more brown sugar, and then I'm gonna pour this pineapple chunks all down on it and get this guy going. Oh yes. And the video that I have on the ham, I give an amount of brown sugar, but use whatever you want. I didn't even measure or anything this time, so do what you will. Look at that in there. So good. All right, got my ham bagged up. I'll get that in the fridge and we're good to go. Dinner is cooking. The rolls are doing an awesome job thawing for tonight and for tomorrow. I have my list on the fridge, and I will be making the strawberry pretzel salad with Shaylee. She's so excited to do that. But right now I am gonna work on an apple pie. I'm using Granny Smith and Honeycrisp apples.
Oh, get in the bowl. Oh geez, what a mess.
Got my 8 apples. If I need more, if I think like once I get it in the pan, if I need more, I'll add more. So I need my cinnamon, my nutmeg, my sugar, and some cornstarch. All right, I put more cinnamon than her recipe calls. I usually do 2 teaspoons or even more. I just love a good cinnamony apple pie. So there's 2 teaspoons. And then I'm gonna actually put 1/2 teaspoon of nutmeg. My mom has written down 1/4, 1/2. Well, actually that was 1 teaspoon, that was not 1/2. Oh well, whatever, it's gonna be delicious. Now I've seen recipes where people have cooked their apples or put them in raw like this, like I'm gonna do. What do you do? So I was debating today, but I didn't want to experiment today. I'll experiment another time. What do you guys do? All right, I'm using store-bought crust. I promise I will experiment with pie crust this month. Nah, don't give up on me, okay? All right, I'm gonna pour my apple mixture in. Oh, this smells so good. Oh yeah, I am stacking this. Well, I definitely don't need more apples. That was perfect. This could have been 8 or 9 apples. So now I'm gonna take some butter and put little pats on top. My mom puts little 5 pats of butter. I'm already past 5. I'm just gonna put whatever on. Now I'm gonna add my crust, but I'm gonna try to do it lattice with this. I'm gonna get creative. Wow, I've never done that before, friends. Didn't do it quite right, but figuring it out. So I'm gonna try to make some nice looking crusty edge.
This is what I got going on. Tried to flute the edges as best as I could, but it's kind of weird, but it works. I've never done a lattice, you guys, ever. So yeah, we'll see how it comes out.
I have an egg here and I'm gonna add a tablespoon of sugar. I'm going to beat this together and then we're gonna rub this on the pie crust. All right. We're gonna start this in the oven at 400 degrees for 15 minutes and then 350 for 45. Well, that was fun and interesting. All right, so I have some of my apple slices, core parts in my little slow cooker pot. I'll end up putting some water and spices in there and turn it on and it'll just make the house smell so good. And now I'm just gonna clean up this mess before I start on the next thing. All right, whoever had kitchen did not empty the dishwasher. They're all upstairs hanging out. The boys did their chores today. They worked very hard. So now they're getting their screen time in. I'm just gonna empty this and make it quick. The house is quiet because they're all upstairs hanging out and I'm like getting stuff done. So once I get the Jell-O salad going, I'll bring Shaylee down because she's really excited to make that with me. So I'm gonna empty the dishwasher, get this cleaned up, and then we'll move on to the next dishes. All right, this has been going for almost 2 hours. I ended up adding another cup of vinegar in. So I'll pay it some attention in a little while. I'll just let it do its thing some more. It is strong. You wanna be able to whiff it and it makes you cough. That's how you know you're right there. And there's the blueberry pie, you guys. It's cooling down, it's gorgeous. And I can't wait to dig into it tomorrow. Yum. All right, so now I've got 2 bricks of cream cheese thawing out. We want them room temperature, so I just have them on my stove, just loosening up. One is for the strawberry Jell-O salad, pretzel salad, and then one is for the shrimp dip. Okay, the shrimp dip is made and going in the fridge. Oh, it'll taste so much better tomorrow. Yum, yum. All right, I drained all the juice that was in there. All right, I added a couple of tablespoons of butter and anywhere from 1/4 cup to 1/2 cup of sugar. And then you stir this in, and there you have it. You can let it cook for a little bit longer, and you've got your red cabbage.
Would you look at that? Look how pretty. Well, we'll find out if it's any good tomorrow. And there's the blueberry. So hopefully Boston really wants an apple pie, and I hope it's delicious for him. So now I'm gonna start on some green bean casserole. Good old fashioned green bean casserole.
I do have a video on how to make like homemade green bean casserole with like cream and cut green beans and milk and not cream of mushroom soup. I am using cream of mushroom soup with regular mushrooms and all that. It's so, so good. I was debating whether or not to make it this year, and then I was like, I have everything already in my food storage for regular good old fashioned green bean casserole. So I was like, let's just do that this year.
Hey, I know you guys wanted to see Paige. Here she is. She's just cleaning my kitchen as I go along. But not only do I have one little cleaner, I have two cleaners. This is Coley. You guys might remember him, everybody that's been here for a long time. Coley! He is the funniest thing. Come here, Coley. Come here. Hi. You want to see the funniest thing? Hey, girl. What you doing? Hey, girl. Who's that girl? Who's that girl? It's Jess. Oh my gosh. He's so cute.
Do you have any bigger ones than this?
He sings the song. He is so funny. Hi, sweetheart. We get to watch him while Uncle Josh is gone, because he's in Texas visiting family with Derek's parents for Thanksgiving. Oh, look, there's a spoon. What do you know?
What do you know?
Oh my.
So I've got two helpers that are running me over in the kitchen, but in just a little while, I'll have four running me over. Callie and Felix are bringing their two dogs, Canyon and Annie. So we're gonna have four dogs running around. All right, pour this in. All right, so we'll put the toppings on. Well, after it's cooked for a while. Okay, I'm gonna keep a cup of this out for a pop. Clean up this part of the kitchen.
Hurry now, should have been done by now. Seems we're running late. Let's put the food on the table. Fast as we're able, guests are coming at 8. When we're caught in the Christmas rush, it's so easy to lose touch with the true meaning of things and what really matters. Just look up. Down to see what's hidden beneath the Christmas tree. Look but not touch, they're told. When
we're right, just cooling off the red cabbage. Derek's getting ice to put in his brine. Oh boy.
He just transferred it to a cool pot so it could cool off faster instead of, because he's got to get it cooled down. Yeah, so before he could get it in. The turkey in it, so this has got to cool. There's our bird.
All right, the green bean casserole is done. I have the amount that I want to put on it tomorrow. I'm going to reheat it up tomorrow with the topping on, so it'll be nice and thicker and not runny.
All right, I am working on some potatoes for dinner tonight. Just quartered some new potatoes, gorgeous purple and yellow potatoes. So now I'm gonna grab garlic, olive oil, and salt. All right, so some olive oil, fresh chopped or minced garlic, some salt. And I love putting thyme and tarragon on my potatoes. Give this a toss. All right, this is going in a 400 degree oven for about 35, maybe 40 minutes. I'll keep an eye on it.
I thawed out a big round thing of shrimp. It was in that. Thawed it out as best as I could, and these are still somewhat frozen, but they're on this tray here, and I'm gonna wrap this all up and get it in the fridge for tomorrow.
All right, we are ready. Table is set, the rolls are out. We have an extra seat, perfect for a grandbaby, whenever that will be. So we are set for dinner.
Oh, these potatoes look awesome. They smell so good.
And then I'm sauteing up some asparagus.
I see why it's easy for
you. Hi, you got so big.
So it doesn't feel like you
swallowed. Oh, Paige is so excited to see Callie and Felix.
Get that energy out.
She has such skinny legs.
Oh, hi, Annie. You got big too.
She got a little bit bigger when we saw her.
Mr. King.
Look at our grand fur dogs. What do they call them? Grand fur pups. Oh.
Grand fur puppies.
Hi, guys. So Derek found this bucket today at Bed Bath & Beyond.
It's a new brine bucket.
A brine bucket, so it makes it so your turkey will stay down in the brine. It clicks in the levels. Look at all that ham. All right, dishwasher is running, dishes are done. So now it's late. It is literally 11:17. Shaylee is gonna make the Jell-O salad with me, and then she's getting to bed. So had a late night, but it's been so fun.
Well,
yeah, keep crushing with the rolling pin. Good job. Okay, Shaylee helped me make the strawberry pretzel salad, so now it's gonna go in the refrigerator to set up.
Good morning, friends. Happy Thanksgiving. I got up maybe an hour ago, and I put the deviled eggs in the Instapot. But do you remember my list from yesterday that I shared with you? Do you see something missing? I am missing the stuffing. I am so glad I remembered that, so. I'm getting going on the slow cooker stuffing recipes below. It is so good.
So I am melting down some butter, and I have some chopped onions and celery and mushrooms. Last night I baked a mincemeat pie for grandma.
I didn't go to bed until 1-ish. I did some dishes, some laundry. Waited for the pie to be done. So now I'm hopping on it. Derek is with, I don't know if Boston went. I don't think Boston wanted to wake up, but Jonah had a lacrosse scrimmage at 8, so I wanted to go, but I'm like, I gotta get all this stuff done. And I'm so glad, I mean, I'm sad that I didn't go to the scrimmage, but I forgot to take out my frozen smoked turkey wings for the gravy, so. But you know what? I was a cheerleader in high school, and we would play our rival football team. And so sometimes it was a home game, sometimes it was an away game every other year. So my mom was never at the Thanksgiving football games to watch me cheer and, you know, be with the whole town because she was home cooking. Oh, such fun memories.
Okay, my veggies are in with my stuffing mix, 2 eggs, and 2 cups of broth that I'm starting with. We'll see if we end up using 4. All right, I only used 2 cups of the broth and it moistened it just perfectly. So now this is going in the slow cooker. Okay, this will cook on high for about 45 minutes and then we're gonna move it down to low for 4 to 8, however you wanna do it. I check it after a while. I do fluff it up periodically and sometimes I move my lid sideways on it or I'll put a paper towel in to collect the moisture because I don't want an over soggy stuffing. So I really do baby this. I check it, I fluff it, rotate it often because I don't want it soggy. Derek's getting the smoker all ready to go. His bird is out of the brine, washed up, and then basted his bird. 10:30 in the morning and we already have the Griswold family Christmas up, Christmas vacation. Every Thanksgiving. And now I am working on deviled eggs. All right, Derek's getting that bird ready. Oh, I can't wait.
So he's got his butter and herbs he's working on right now. That's going under the skin. And then he learned and saw how to use mayonnaise on top of the bird.
Yeah, people are using mayonnaise, or give it a shot.
So he's gonna give it a shot this year.
So it keeps you from having to baste because it breaks down and slower.
So he's working on that with all the seasonings. I finally found rosemary. I had a hard time finding some. Smith's didn't have any, Walmart didn't have any, and I traveled up to Harmon's and they had a ton, so I was excited to see that. So that's mayonnaise and...
with all the seasonings.
Tons of seasonings and maple syrup. Is it a garlic pepper rub?
With a little bit of heat with chipotle.
Oh yes, I love it. Well, it's gonna be interesting with the mayonnaise. If any of you done it with the mayonnaise, let me know down below. I tried a new way of curling my hair that Callie taught me. Doesn't look as good as her hair, but I tried. It's when you wrap the hair around the barrel. I'm not very good at it, but all right, the apps are disappearing. They're doing a good job eating them. That was breakfast to lunch. So, yeah, I decided, yeah, I'm not making a breakfast casserole. We'll have appetizers, and it was perfect, so. You got all cleaned up. All right, so while I was getting ready, Derek disinfected the area. I'm gonna start on the gravy because it takes like, an hour and a half to simmer, I believe. So I got this recipe from Joanne Henderson. She sent it out to me. It was so sweet, like a couple years ago, I think. Maybe we're on 3 years now, and I made it 1 year, and it is seriously the best turkey gravy. I can't find just raw, like, turkey wings. I don't know where I'm gonna have to, maybe Harmon's. I just never lived near Harmon's, and now I do. So maybe they have fresh turkey wings, and I can see if they have them, but I did what I did the first time is I went to Walmart, and I got the frozen smoked turkey wings. They're already cooked, and you're supposed to, like, put them in the oven and get the drippings off. So basically, you start this recipe after the roasting. So you put the wings in a large pot with water and the veggies and the herbs and let them cook. And oh my gosh, so good. The flavor from the smoke of the wings, oh my word. I tried to do it 1 year with smoked turkey drumsticks, not the same. I thought I could duplicate it because I couldn't find the wings, but I found the drumsticks. No, that didn't come out so good. No, so you gotta have the wings. So I'll be making her recipe, and what I love about it is she left a note on it and things.
Yes, I love her note. I love this. So thank you, Joanne. Just thank you so much. I've always wanted a good turkey gravy, and you gave that to me. So thank you.
Okay, I'm at the point in the stuffing where I'm putting a paper down to collect the moisture because it does not need any moisture. It looks good. There's enough moisture, so I want it to cook, but dry out a bit, if that makes any sense. So it's a process. All right, it is 1 o'clock. And I'm going to start on the gravy. Hi, Annie. You've gotten so big. You're such a good girl. Aww. And so, Canyon is Annie's boyfriend. Canyon. Yeah, you're a cougar, Annie, because they're going to have babies. Callie and Felix are going to be breeding dogs, huh? Canyon, happy Thanksgiving, cutie. You're so cute. You getting sleepy now that you played? Yeah, you're feeling sleepy now. They played hard outside. Now they're getting really sleepy.
Derek and I just went outside to take a picture. It is chilly today. The town where we used to live in Payson, they got snow. And so I saw everyone's pictures on Instagram and it's absolutely gorgeous. So now, got my sweater on. I am freezing. I am gonna wait to start on the gravy because it only takes an hour and a half and the turkey won't be done until I think 5. So I'm gonna wait a little bit. I'm gonna sit and play with the family.
Grammy's book.
You got Grammy's book?
You know, the old book?
The old cookbook. Hey, Ma, say hi. Hey everybody.
Hi, happy Thanksgiving.
Oh, it's so cold. It's so cold. Whew. It's cold out there. Well, Callie and Felix just left. Sad, sad day, but they're gonna go have a yummy dinner with his family. So they had appetizers here. Okay, so Derek and Felix moved the smoker more underneath the deck, closer to the house.
Get it out of the wind.
The wind is so bad right now. It's cold, and it just couldn't get the temperature right with the turkey. So it's doing good. It's smoking away really good right now. So, yep, so that is cooking. The boys want more pumpkin pie. We're down to one pumpkin pie, and that's not gonna be enough. So, I got a big can here. I'm gonna make two more pies. This big guy here, this 29 ounce can, will make two pumpkin pies. So I'm gonna hurry and get these into the oven. No. Look at this bird. It's gorgeous. Oh, look at that bird.
She's spread eagle.
Pumpkin pies are done. I just put in my sweet potatoes.
Okay, turkey's over there resting. And while everything else is cooking, we are set to go. So we'll clear off the table, but everyone's playing games on it right now. And so we're gonna chill. The gravy's still going. I'm gonna make it into gravy in probably about 20 minutes. And then we'll eat in probably about an hour.
Right, the stuffing has been done. I keep it on warm with the cover like this so the steam can vent, and I keep fluffing it, and it is perfect. It's still hot. Gravy has got just a little more to go, and then we can make it all nice and thick and yummy. Oh, he's beauty. All right, we are gonna carve and dish up.
Thank you.
Well, friends, thank you so much for joining us. It was a wonderful Thanksgiving. It was so nice to have Callie and Felix with us last night and be together with just our little family here today. It was so fun. Yummy food. We have leftovers for the weekend and two soups coming up, the split pea soup and the turkey soup. So yes, I hope all of you who celebrate Thanksgiving had a very good Thanksgiving. Thank you so much for joining us, and let the holiday content begin. We will see you soon. Bye.